Today I'd like to talk about the differences between blown glass, fused glass, and torch work. I get asked a lot of questions on what I can make and what I can do, and I want to explain it to you guys right now, so stay tuned. This is a crucible where the molten glass is melted down. The blowpipe is dipped into the furnace to gather the glass. The molten glass sticks to the pipe and is the consistency of honey. Then the glass blower creates a basic shape and blows into the pipe to inflate the glass. Most often, the piece must be reheated during the process using a second furnace called the glory hole. The final furnace is the annealer, in which the finished work is carefully placed to slowly cool so the glass doesn't thermal shock. Glass blowing is used to make large works of art, vases, and globes, which is my personal favorite. Most fusing methods involve designing, cutting, and stacking layers of thin sheets of glass in different colors and sizes and textures. They can create patterns or complex images. The pieces are then placed inside the kiln and can be heated up to 1500 degrees. Often these pieces are fused two or more times for up to 24 hours each time, which includes the annealing process. And then you have lamp work or torch work. Usually beads are made, and I always think this is an absolute fun process. But one of my favorite things is to take fused glass and stained glass and marry the two together in my fused glass boxes. Thanks for watching. If you like my content, consider liking and subscribing to my videos, and sharing always helps an artist out. Thank you.